Corruption remains a key challenge in Uganda despite a flourishing anti-corruption legal framework coupled with a number of government agencies in the fight against it. Government acknowledges that the fight against corruption is still far from over and insists this can be achieved through all its agencies working jointly. With immediate effect, they have ordered the Office of the Inspectorate of Government, Police, Public Accounts Committee of Parliament, public account committees at the district levels, judiciary among others, to share all relevant information about corruption scandals.
Because previously each entity was like acting alone. So that has been presented to cabinet, their joint action, and from now on they have agreed and cabinet has approved the objectives of the policies, which are: one, to firmly renew government's commitment to fight corruption by strengthening synergies, collaboration, and coordination among all stakeholders, both government and government and non-government, for effective implementation of anti-corruption measures. Two, to institute and effectively enforce and corruption measures, which include enforcement and implementation of existing policies. Three, to continue with inculcation of the culture of integrity, accountability, and patriotism at all levels.
This is to be effected through the Zero Tolerance to Corruption Policy 2018, which has been approved by Cabinet. The policy's core objective is to institute and effectively enforce anti-corruption measures.
The objectives of the policies, which are: one, to firmly renew government's commitment to fight corruption by strengthening synergies, collaboration, and coordination among all stakeholders, both government and government and non-government, for effective implementation of anti-corruption measures.
The cabinet has also approved the proposal to borrow 180 billion shillings from World Bank to support refugee host communities in the 12 districts of Arua, Koboko, Yumbe, Moyo, Chiriandongo, Chegwegwa, among others.
And recommended that all the 12 districts in Uganda that are hosting refugees should be considered. Consequently, the concern of Parliament has been considered, has been taken into consideration, and therefore all the 12 districts that are hosting refugees are going to benefit from, one, the loan of 87.5 and also the grant of 62.5 million USD.
This report was filed by Jaliat Namwaya for Urban TV. So cool.